at it, but you're gonna wake up. By the way, I have something on your shirt.
Gotcha.
So what you been up to since you get back into town? You doing the normal?
You one of my fans?
No, I mean you being incredibly lazy. But for real though, I missed you.
Missed you too, Lucy.
Hey, handsome. Hey, loser. Got 2 seconds, so I'm busting this door down. One. Two. All right, I'm coming in. Hey, Mom. Hey, Mom?
Hey, Olive.
Hey, Xavier. You still doing all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why? What's up?
Oh, nothing. Just wanted to make sure you're still doing alright.
Yeah, I'm fine. No need to worry about me. Do you still want to hang out later?
How's your mom? Is she doing alright?
Yeah, I think she's visiting Hector. Anywho, do you want to go grab something to eat?
Yeah, sounds good.
Great. I'll beat you there.
You want to bet?
Already winning.
I win.
That's only because I was driving the speed limit, unlike some other delinquents in this town.
Oh yeah? Because you are such an angel, huh?
I try hard to conceal it.
How are you feeling? Like, genuinely?
I'm fine.
Hey guys, my name's Maria. May I get you started with something to drink?
I would love some Sprite if I could.
Is Sierra Mr. right?
Yeah, Sierra Mrs. okay.
I'll do the same.
Great, I'll have this out for you in just a minute.
They were nice, weren't they?
Yeah.
So,
you talking to anyone?
Not really. Haven't really found anyone who can
keep up with you?
No. Afford me.
Trust me, I know.
And here you guys are. And have you guys decided on what you like to eat, or do you need more time?
I think we need a little bit more time to decide.
Okay, great. Just call me over when you're ready.
Haven't really met a lot of people, you'd say.
Maybe two? Probably just one?
Yeah, I guess you could say that. Why do you ask?
Don't worry, it's not me asking.
Oh? Then who is it?
A friend?
Yeah? And who might this friend be?
They don't go to our school. You wouldn't know them.
Oh, I bet. So, what are you thinking about getting?
Do you really have to ask?
Oh, yeah. I forgot. You're boring.
Listen, I just know what I like. What can I say?
Okay, then I will get this. One of us has to be at least a little bit adventurous.
Yeah, that makes one of us.
Have you guys decided what you like to eat?
I will get the French toast, and he will get the number one, please.
All right, I'll have those out for you in just a moment.
You're a senior in high school, and you still can't order for yourself?
Listen.
Oh, I'm listening.
I'm paying.
Yes. Yes, you are.
Are you super busy as of recently?
I mean, not really, just work, but you know.
Okay. Well, if you want to go on more adventures, I think I can help you with that.
Oh, really? I would love to see you try.
And here you guys are.
Wow, that was fast.
We microwaved it. Thank you.
Was she joking?
Well, either way, we have food in front of us, so.
Good point. Hey, Olive.
Yeah?
Would you like to go to a mini golf course with me? Or not? It's up to you.
Of course, I'd love to. I'm not busy now if you want to go.
Oh, yeah? Want to ride?
I could drive.
Yeah, I just thought it'd be nice if we spent some more time together.
Just don't drive too fast.
I know. I'm a speed demon. Yo, Gus. Is that you?
Yo, what's up, man?
What you been up to?
Nothing, man. I just started working here like 2 months ago. It's not really my dream job, but pays the bills. Haven't seen your brother around here in a while. How's he been?
I don't know. He's got himself into a pretty nice college, but that's about it.
Nice.
So how much will it be for the two clubs?
20, but I got you for 10.
Yo, thanks, bro.
You're welcome, bro.
I'll talk to you later.
Hey, tell your brother I said hi.
All right.
See you, bro.
Hope it's not too big for you.
Sometimes I really hate you.
Admit it. You love me.
So, are you going to the fair?
I didn't even think about it. When is it?
Tomorrow's tomorrow.
You know, you are so weird sometimes.
But hey, you love me. This is Hector and I's favorite hole.
Oh, was it?
It still is.
Listen, can we talk on the way home?
Yeah, I mean, sure.
See that factory over there? Hector and I used to break into it all the time. I mean, totally legal, obviously. I remember how he would always go to the top, but I would stay lower because I was scared of heights. I would see him up there, taking pictures of the land, and imagine what it would be like up there with him. Obviously, it was terrifying. I mean, what was it? 70 feet? But it felt like more like 200. Seeing him up there, taking those pictures, it felt such a surreal memory.
It was really nice hanging out with you today. We should do it again sometime.
Yeah, I'd like that. Talk to you later, okay?
I'll be waiting.
You better be.
Hey, Mom. I'm just gonna go to my room. Hey, Mom, could you get the door?
Get a shirt on.
All right.
So not much has changed. Still too slow.
What was that for?
I just want to mess with you a little. I'm just giving you a hard time.
Well, hey, at least I have a girl.
Olive? Are you actually talking to her? I thought you were just crushing on her. Didn't know the feelings were mutual.
I wasn't crushing.
Liking girl for years and years. Yeah, at that point, it's more than crushing.
I don't need to take this.
Hey, go for a drive?
Man, if I didn't have a car and saved all my gas money, I could pay for your gas and my college.
Just shut up and let me the car.
What?
Man, the service here is horrid.
Oh, I'm so sorry. As you should. Where to, brother?
I'll give you directions, don't worry.
All right, whatever you say.
So you and Olive, tell me more about that.
I mean, I like her, but I'm not sure if she likes me back. I mean, maybe I'm just oblivious.
You probably are.
Well, if I was, then I think I would realize if she likes me or not. Well, maybe just a little. I don't want to ruin it. But I don't know how long we've known each other for.
Almost 10 years.
10 years?
That's weird. I don't like that.
Let's be honest, the worst she could say is no.
No, let's be honest. The worst she can say is, ew, no! I saw you as a brother. I'm never gonna talk to you again.
Okay, well, that's a little dramatic. I mean, it fits you. But I bet it'll be fine.
Yeah, I guess I've been stuck on her for a while.
Okay, let me ask you a question. If you asked her out, what would you do if she said no?
Cry.
Okay, well then what if she says yes?
Cry, but happily.
Fine, smart Alec. What would you do to try and preserve the relationship?
I'll probably just, I don't know, be more adventurous. Try to spend some more time with her. Make sure she's happy. You know, I don't want her feeling unwanted. You know?
Not knowing you have a rough idea.
I know. I'm just a natural genius.
I'm gonna have to get out of the car.
Why?
I don't know how much longer I can fit in here with your giant head.
I hate you so much. Oh, but for real though, like, what have you been up to? I've been talking most of the time. It's your turn.
Honestly, not much.
Wow. Get a load of this guy for doing not much. Let's give him an award for being so interesting. But you have to have something interesting. Like, what's college like?
Pretty empty and cold.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you were here, it'd probably be 10 times better.
Yeah, I know. I'm literally the best.
It's getting pretty cramped in here.
You know, it's gonna be weird not seeing you for next break.
Yeah. But you'll survive.
Wait, which way do we turn?
Take a left 2 roads from here.
We're going to the park?
Yeah. Just want to stretch my legs a little bit.
So, have you been meeting anyone lately?
You kidding me? You might be handsome, but I don't have the game that you have.
I mean, you know the same. Hate the player, not the game.
You know, it's been a while since we hung out like this.
I know. It might be a while till we get to you again. I'm not going to be in town much longer.
More of a reason to make most of the night.
Well, I gotta get back to where I was staying soon. But I can stay here a bit longer.
You better. If you made me come out to this park for no reason and start driving again, I would be so annoyed. So, you're not staying with us at home? You're staying with someone else?
No, I can't stay at home this time.
So you're staying with a friend?
Yeah.
That was awfully suspicious.
So?
So what?
So college. What you thinking?
Probably just some little Ivy League. Small like Harvard. Might pursue being a lawyer.
Really?
No. Are you kidding me? I could barely afford gas at the time.
Okay then, serious answer.
I'm thinking about maybe majoring in English.
Oh, so you're looking at the big bucks, huh? You excited about having Alice's mom as your professor?
You know, I could easily toss you into that lake.
No, you couldn't. I wish we were closer this last year. I know we haven't really talked much.
I understand. You're in college and I've been working on finishing up with school.
True. really proud of you, you know?
What?
I don't think I ever got to tell you, but you're such a good brother. Like, remember the time we were having a Nerf war and I tripped and hurt my knee?
Yeah, I pulled a France.
It was you who decided to help me, even though I was in no man's land.
I mean, you weren't that bad yourself. You were always do my homework and gave me the answers. Honestly, I don't think I would have passed without you, man. You were always there when I needed you. And I want to remind you that I would always do the same.
Let me start by answering your calls once in a while. But yeah, you don't start changed. You said you were looking into English. You still writing? No, I struggle with it.
I don't know. I don't write as much as I used to. I still write more than the average person, but more of just an occasional poem.
You should get back into it. You're pretty good at it. Plus, it'll probably help you with colleges.
No, yeah. Although it would be hard leaving Mama alone, you should talk to her somewhere. I don't know what's wrong, but I feel like garbage for letting whatever it is just make her feel so sad.
You should talk to her. And she won't kill you. Next time you see her like that, ask if she's okay.
Yeah. Should we start heading back?
Oh. Probably.
Yeah. So anyways, what were you saying?
Just talk to her, man. It doesn't help either of you to just sulk in your feelings.
Okay, so do you remember that little pizza place we went to after school?
Yeah, I mean, it was almost every single time I had money in my account.
Oh, wait, I just remembered. You had the biggest crush on that cashier there, and you never told me. That's why we would always go.
Yeah, what can I say? She was cute.
She was out of your league. Plus, you never had the courage to ask.
I tried once or twice.
Yeah. I do remember that. It was so sad.
I don't need to take this.
What you gonna do? Leave?
I'll just walk.
Be my guest.
Maybe I will.
Did you ever remember her name? Oh my God. You didn't even remember her name. Man, I wish it was still open. I wonder, does she still work there?
There's no way she does. No way.
That would be insanely funny if she did, though.
Okay, let's just change the subject. I dare you that the next time you see Olive, you have to ask her out.
All right, bet. But only if...
Oh, God.
Only if... You do the same.
Fine. Deal.
You know, I'm proud of you too.
We've been through so much that I've never been able to display how much I've actually cared. We've had our fights, and we've pissed each other off. But I think I should let you know that I am always here for you. I'll do anything to make sure you're safe. It's you and I.
I am holding you to that. Well, anyways, we should head out.
All right, Mr. Wasting My Gas a Lot. Where would you like the chauffeur to take you this evening?
801 Sheedley Avenue.
I'm gonna be honest, I have no idea where that is, so just direct me.
Okay, what turn?
Just right up here, take a left.
Wait, left or right?
Left.
Okay, you need to be more clear in your directions.
Just take a left here, then.
Wait, right here?
I understand why I used to drive.
Well, tell your friends that I said hi.
I will. Door.
I hate you.
Here you are, good sir. Make sure you do keep warm out there. I hope you have an excellent day.
I'll miss you, loser. I'll see you again.
See ya, bro.
Hey, Mom. I just want to talk to you. Is there anything I can do to help? Okay, I understand. Just talk to me when you can.
Honestly, I've just been feeling a little off today.
Yeah? Any reason why?
Not really. Although, it was nice to talk to my brother yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah, I told him about all of it.
Oh yeah? How two you doing anyway?
I really don't know.
Well, you know how women can be. Mixed signals and all.
Well, if I didn't know that before, I do now.
Okay, you learned the lesson. Have I ever told you how I met my wife?
No, I don't think you have.
Well, I was in church, and I noticed that she was going to be late again. Well, she was one of our speakers that day, and I decided to pull a joke on her.
What'd you do?
I told everyone in our small congregation to stand up and clap when she walked in. Oh, I've never seen her more embarrassed than that.
What'd she do?
Well, when she realized it was me because of my big grin, she walked right over to me and hit me in the stomach.
She punched you in the stomach?
Yeah.
Like with her fist?
Yep. That's when I fell in love.
I've never been punched in the stomach before, but I've been smacked once.
Oh yeah? What'd you do to deserve that?
We were out shopping and she found something that she really liked. She asked me to be honest. Lesson learned.
That's one learned the hard way for sure.
You know, I'm thinking about asking her out next time I see her.
You gonna ask if she wants to go to the fair tomorrow?
I don't know. I mean, I brought it up to her before and she didn't seem like she was that interested. Plus, I was gonna work the car.
Don't worry about the cart. I can manage that. I'll call Barbara and see if she can help.
You better watch her fists.
Yeah, lesson learned. You know, Olive's a real sweet girl. I bet you all will get together just fine.
Really? Thanks, Mark.
Yeah, you do what you need to do. Just remember to wear an extra shirt. Oh, speak of the devil, I'll be in the back.
Oh, hey, what are you doing here?
I was just about to start my shift at the boutique and I thought I'd stop by. What are you doing here?
I work here. You know that.
Yeah, I know. I'm just messing with you.
Yeah, I know that. So I was wondering...
Oh?
I was wondering if you would like to go to the fair with me tomorrow. It's okay if you don't want to. I was just wondering.
Yes, Xavier. I would love to go to the fair with you tomorrow. You know, you are such a nervous wreck sometimes.
That's always refreshing to hear.
Hey, one of us has to be honest.
I'm glad one of us can.
How much would this be, Xavier?
$250. I'll ring you up.
Here. And you can keep the change.
Thanks for the 63 cents.
What can I say? I'm a big spender.
Oh, I can tell.
Here. You have a good one, Xavier. I'll see you tomorrow. You better be on time.
Oh, I will.
I won't even worry about it. Bye, Mark.
Bye, Olive.
Hey, Hector. Just wondering if you would like to hang out sometime soon. I know you're busy, but I kind of miss you. If you're able to get your lazy butt up and answer, that would be great. I'm guessing you won't, though, because of said lazy butt. Just let me know where you want to go and when. I'll make it happen. Oh! I feel like I should tell you this. I asked Olive out to the fair. I heard how Mark and his wife met. Don't really want that happening. But if that's where the spark comes from, I guess I can't complain too much. Anyways, just wanted to hear your voice and talk to you again. Get back to me when you can. Bye, loser.
can I help you today? Hey, buddy.
Yeah?
Looking for something?
No, I'm just browsing. Take these. No. Sorry. No. No, thank you.
Okay.
Hey, sweetie. Hey, Mom. Are you doing all right?
Yeah, I am. Thanks. Hey, I wanted to ask you a favor.
Yeah, what's up?
Well, on your way home, could you pick up some groceries, please? I can transfer some money over for you.
Is it okay if I do it in the morning? I think I need to get some sleep.
Oh, yeah, sure, that's fine. Just go ahead and come on home.
All right, Mom. I'll pick up the groceries in the morning.
Okay. You know, I'm gonna go ahead and get ready for bed, so I'll just see you tomorrow. Okay, sweetie?
Good night, Mom.
Good night.
Hey, Mom. How are you?
I'm feeling better.
I'm glad. What you making?
Well, I'm just cooking the remainder of the eggs and toasting some bread. Oh, well, was toasting.
Wow. We really do need some groceries, don't we?
Listen, hon, I don't need your sass.
Hey, I'm sensitive.
Oh, what? You're sensitive just there?
I'm glad making fun of me makes you happy, Mom.
It always will, son.
Oh, thanks.
Anytime, sweetie. Poke.
So, what do we need concerning groceries?
Well, we need ham, milk, eggs, cereal, chips, and bread. Do you need me to write that down?
If possible.
Okay. I'm so glad to know that my son has such a great memory. Okay. So, ham, eggs, milk, cereal, and bread. Okay. There you go.
Thank you. I'll go get them.
Okay, good.
Once I'm done eating all this food.
Okay. Lacy bones.
Hey.
Thank you. I understand that, but the sticker on the back says buy one, get one. That means I get one for free, not pay for both.
Ma'am, I understand. The BOGO coupon isn't registering in our system yet.
Fine. I'll take my business elsewhere.
Sorry about that.
What? Oh. It's okay. Honestly, you get used to it after a certain point.
Yeah, but should you?
I mean, what can you do?
I mean, I feel like it's less about what you can do and more about what they can do.
Yeah, I guess so. Scam?
Oh, no, no. I'll just let them leave a voicemail.
Alright. Well, it'll be 1625.
You can keep the change.
Thanks.
Just text me, okay? Bye.
New message.
Hey, man. Xavier, please. Xavier, please. Just pick up the phone. Please come home. I need you. I need someone to talk to. No one listens anymore.
Where is he?
Honey, calm down.
Where is he?
Where is who?
Hector.
What are you talking about?
Please, I need to help him.
Xavier, you know what happened. Please, Xavier, you know what happened. Say something. Please. Why are you making me go through this again? Stop it!
Mom, please. I just need to know what happened.
About a week ago, I got a call from work. The police were at our house. Hector had locked himself in the bathroom. I came off as soon as I could. And I called you as soon as I found out. I don't know how to tell you this. Brother's been dead for a week. He took his own Wait, don't go, please.
Ready for the fair?
Please tell me he's not dead. Please, I need to know. I can't. He's still here. I know he's still here. Please, he can't be gone. I know he's still here. I saw him. We're at the park. He was just here. He was just here.
Say, what is going on?
I swear, Hector, he was just here.
What?
I don't know.
Come here. Hey, listen to me. I'm here for you. I promise. I want you to be safe. I know it's hard. It wasn't easy for me when I found out. My mom still has these from when she was his English professor. I just didn't know how to give them to you.
How long?
Say.
How long?
No, no, no. This can't be true.
Say, please, don't do anything dangerous.
Do anything dangerous? My brother killed himself, Olive. In my house, he called me, begging me to come home. Didn't answer. We were brothers, and I left him. I let him die, and I'm gonna have to live with that for the rest of my life, knowing I could have changed that, knowing he won't be at my graduation, knowing that we won't ever sing songs ever again. And you expect me, his own brother, not to do anything dangerous? I would do anything to see him again.
Hector Castilla. Title, Sunsets at Noon. Happiness can be a tricky thing. It can lift you up or make you sing, but sometimes it can cloud our sight and fill our hearts with a delusional light. We convince ourselves that all is well and push aside the doubts and fears. But as time goes on and the veil is lifted, we see that our happiness was just a gift. It's easy to get caught up in the bliss, to let it consume us and make us miss the signs that something's not quite right, that our happiness is just a facade and we're living in a lie. But even when the truth is clear, we may hold on to our happiness in fear, the unknown, the pain, the heartache that may come. And so we cling to our happiness even when it's done. For sometimes the sun sets at noon and our happiness disappears way too soon. But eventually we must face the truth and learn to let go of our happiness, no matter how uncouth. It may seem at first, for it's only by facing the real that we can find true happiness and heal.